Welcome back to Driven Daily. One of the projects that we've been working on over the winter is the 1999 box truck that I picked up. It's an E350 and it's got the venerable 7.3 liter turbo diesel. And mechanically, this thing is a beast. It's amazing. I picked it up for $2,500 up in northern Vermont, and it used to be a roofing truck. But at one point, a big bin of roofing tar that was pressurized and heated apparently exploded and just blew up all over the inside of the box truck. So we nicknamed it the Murder Van. Since then, we've pretty much rebuilt the inside of the box, and we've done a bunch of other work to it to support that. So we've replaced the rear doors with swinging doors. It had overhead doors, but the cable and the spring on that broke, so it was pretty much impossible to open or close the thing. So the barn doors allow us to mount tools and lights to the insides of the doors and makes it so that one person can open the truck. We added a tow hitch and we've started adding the tow wiring so that we can pull the open trailer behind it, which is going to have a race car on it. In addition to that, we've added some lighting into the cab and on the front. So the original headlights are kind of like holding two little dying candles out in front of the truck. And when you're driving to a race event at night in the rain, they just don't cut it. So we picked up some Jeep LED headlights, which apparently bolt right in, and they were a perfect fit. And I couldn't be happier with them. For about $150, we've got some of the best headlights that are also DOT certified that are available to this truck. Inside the cab, we added a couple of USB chargers, a CB radio, so that we can talk to all the other cars that are caravanning with us, and we've added some overhead lights. So we took the 3528 LED strips and we put a meter of those inside the cab, and because they're just 12 volt strips, we wired them straight into the normal overhead cab lights. So you get an overwhelming amount of light whenever you open the passenger's door. So we still have a bit more work to do before the first race event, and we're not quite ready to tow a car behind it yet. So we'll have a few more episodes on that before a Scutney in 2 months. That's coming up in May. Because of the amount of work that we have to do on the box truck still before the first race event, we've created a new playlist specifically for the race support vehicle. So if you're interested in the kind of background logistics work that goes into running a racing team, head on over to that playlist and you can see all the videos that we've produced. As always, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.